does a hero's journey begin? The moment you step outside the safety of your homes, or when you realize the fight has just begun? Is it when you comprehend how small you are compared to the vastness?
Greetings, everyone. Jay, the Filthy Kaz here. So, if you haven't heard, WoTC fired a bunch of people again. I guess the quarterly report for January is coming out soon. It's one way to save a bunch of money. Poor people. So basically, I've seen this from Saffron Olive come across Twitter. Basically, what had happened was Wizards had either not renewed the contract or terminated the contract, or from what a person who actually works there states, they found a workaround the contract so they could basically force them to not do the work by not paying them enough. So this is surprising considering their last four quarterly reports have all been up until I think January 17 were all profitable. But as you know, all the red flags have been going on, the profitability or the profits were coming after massive cuts. I think the last quarter they let go of a bunch of contracted artists or something to that effect. Basically, we're going to take a look at this here. Now, I don't believe in Reddit. I hate Reddit. I don't like the RMTG or MTGO forums, but it is what it is. So, no more orcs is what the title was. So, Wizards has cut loose all of the orcs who were contracted with WoTC to provide chat and email support. They said that they are going to outsource to a company in India. Turnaround time on email responses will soon be awful. This means MTGO reimbursements, arena tech supports and refunds, product replacement and DCI account help will also be slow. And it goes on to a person who's using a throwaway account, which is basically posting this on a throwaway account since I don't want to connect it to my main account. I was going to make my own post about this, but I noticed this one, so I decided to comment on it instead. Until just a few days ago, I worked for WoTC as a part of their customer support team, better known as ORCs, Online Response Crew. We are the folks who answer MTGO support chat, process your reimbursements, moderate the MTG Arena forums, answer your support emails and phones, moderate the Twitch chat, and generally provide most frontline support for Magic the Gathering, Dungeons and Dragons, and various other games that Wizards of the Coast offers. A little backstory on how this works. Wizards of the Coast has a small internal support team that does very similar work, but a majority of the support is handled by a company called the Productive Associates Incorporated, PAI, which I and the rest of the orcs work for. We live all over the United States and Canada and have been working from home providing support for Wizards of the Coast for over a decade. Every single one of us has had a background in either Magic, D&D, or both. Most of us have been working here for years and have developed an extensive knowledge of Wizards of the Coast products and how to support them. On Wednesday of last week, Wizards of the Coast decided to abruptly end their contract with PAI, and the majority of the team was laid off with no warning. A small portion of the team will be kept on until the end of the month, and then they will be let go as well. This was through no fault of ours, as everyone within and outside the company has been nothing but impressed with the support that we've been providing. Apparently, new upper management, not naming any names, has determined our services are too expensive and has decided to replace us with a large international support company, Reed, Italian customer support. Sorry, Indian customer support. I imagine if it was Italian, they'd have the E. Without even so much as a courtesy transition period. We were told that our services would no longer be needed and that we were unemployed, effective immediately. We will get no severance or any other sort of compensation. Apparently, Wizards of the Coast has no loyalty towards the people that have been providing them with top-tier customer service for over a decade. Considering that this contract was a majority portion of PAI's overall revenue, it could also spell the end of PAI. In conclusion, I'm sorry to rant to you fine folks here, but I feel that you all deserved a heads up. In the quality of support that you receive in the coming months falls drastically in quality, at least you know why. I've enjoyed serving the MTG and D&D communities for the years that I've worked here, and I will really miss interacting with you all. So this seems really heartfelt, and it was only put up 4 hours ago at the time of this filming. Some of the comments are pretty lit. I saw one here about the moderated chat. So right here, who will moderate the Twitch chat? And then the first response is, oh no, don't tell me they tried the subscriber only chat for this reason. Probably. It's one way to moderate it. Pay to get heard, right? And then it goes on to like inappropriate usernames being siphoned out, and people go on to say like how long the orcs have been working there. One person here was all the way back in the Adept program, which goes all the way back to the very beginning. It goes on to like talk about it's complicated, or a multi-billion-dollar company off the hook for their shitty decisions. Have you tried turning your commander back off and back on? Is one of the comments. Kindly send the screenshots of the error and we will do what we need. So it seems like now tinfoil hat here, because a lot of the bigger YouTubers won't cover this because they feel that Magic the Gathering is healthy, when in fact it's not. I've been saying it for over a year now. Every time a quarterly report is about to come out, they make a drastic change which shows a profit, and then Hasbro's happy. They did it all year. Now, because the quarterly one's coming out, you're gonna have the Ultimate Masters, you're gonna have the Ravnica, which was okay, and you're gonna have the surplus profits from switching to a new customer support. Which brings me to this. So, these are the customer, or the quarterly reports for first quarter 2018. So it says they showed a decreased value, mostly because of Toys R Us going bankrupt in the US. I mean, you could blame Toys R Us, but even if they liquidated it on sale, they probably made a profit on the overall product. Thus reporting a net loss of $112.5 million, or 90 cents per share. And then it goes on to explain all that. Now, I don't see them taking a huge loss from Toys R Us. I'm sorry, it's just, they buy the product in bulk. It will never be less than what the cost of manufacturing was, plus overhead. So WotC probably sold it direct, they marked it up. Either way, Wizards of the Coast made their money and Hasbro made their money, so I don't justify this being a legitimate or an accurate number represented by Magic. Alright, so quarterly two. So, they show a revenue of $904.5 million, so substantially higher. Well, what happened in July of 2018? Let's see, I think it was Dominaria. MTG, July 2018. Let's see, so Arena, banned and restricted updates, coming soon. Nope, it's already been replaced by the 2019 stuff. I don't want to go back in the way time machine, or the way back machine, to try and find that. But basically, there was something, I think it might have been Dominaria, that came out at that time, which also would have helped their overall value. But they did say the segment revenues were down 7% in Canada and the United States, and the international segments were down by 11%. But the licensing revenues were up. So it seems like the board game industry may have jumped, showing a net profit. But I do know that for the quarterly three report, they had fired a bunch of people and switched over. Switched over. So it jumped from 907 million to 1.57 billion. And this is where all the changes happened, was around August. And this would lead us into the end quarter, which will be coming out shortly. So if it's up 1.57 billion after all that, I mean, these are good numbers. As you see, they started restraining themselves and cutting back in the wrong areas. Card quality is still down. You're cutting loose a bunch of people. I do believe they fired a bunch of customer supports or some management and replaced them with young management in August as well. And don't get me wrong, I like playing Magic. But when I see a red flag, I need to bring light to that flag. Because all of 2018 and part of 2017 was nothing but red flags. It's like, wow, why would they do that? That doesn't make any sense. Right? It's like a restaurant you go to that starts floundering. What's the first thing they do? They cut the quality of the food. Once they cut the quality of the food or cheaper meat, and if sales are still down, they start having to cut staff. Well, if you don't have the skilled staff to cook the already low quality meat, then you're just going to put the last nail in the coffin. So it's a similar concept. If you do enough bad things, eventually you're going to crash. Which brings us to the orcs. This is a big one. If you don't have good customer support, you're done. Your online games are going to flounder. People aren't going to play something they're not going to have the support on. They're not going to get their reimbursements in time, they're not going to get their issues addressed on time, and that creates consumer dissatisfaction. To do what? Obviously save money. To pad the quarterly report. But that's the problem. You're padding the quarterly report and you're not fixing the future. Now, they've said they have a bunch of big sets coming on down the line. Well, that's fine. Paper Magic is probably going to stick around. But if you don't have the online support, you're kind of done. So there's been a lot of red flags, and you can go back and take a look yourself at all the times, like just like a couple months prior to a quarterly report, there'll be a drastic change, but they'll put out something that will cover it. So for July, I believe it was Dominaria, but they also cut some staff. And then in August, I don't recall anything coming out in August, but I do remember them letting go artists. And I think in either September, early September or late September, they had the issue with the artist getting stuck in the airport because they didn't get their work visas done in time, which is probably a cash issue, to be honest. And it's been one thing after another, and now there's their customer support team is going to be lackluster. So just a heads up for all the people who play online for Arena and MTGO, if you're not really well known by the support team, or if you're not probably being under the wing of Wizards of the Coast, then I suspect that your customer service will be quite poor. So that's everything for this video. It's just a quick video bringing you up to date on the orcs, so thanks for watching. I'm Jay the Filthy Casual, former Knight of the Round Table, and current member of the Phoenix Syndicate. If you liked today's video, drop a comment, click like, and subscribe. To be notified of uploads and live streams, don't forget the bell. It's 2019, we have a lot in store for you, like sponsorships from the following. Inked Gaming, the leader in customizable game supplies. A portion of sales will go to the channel. Use promo code TheFilthyCaz to receive special benefits at checkout. That's TheFilthyCaz to receive 10%. And Everything Games, your one-stop shop for everything Warhammer, Keyforge, Magic the Gathering. Online sales now active at www.everythinggames.ca. A special thanks to our Patreons, for you are the brick and mortar that keeps this channel going. Remember, support your local LGS, as they are the brick and mortar of the gaming community. And thanks for watching.